Simply Done, the podcast network.
Sign this like you're signing to somebody. Don't write it to anybody. Just sign it like, hey, keep up the good work. You know, just write something. Hurry. How long is it going to take you to fucking stare at the fucking picture?
I don't like what I got to sign because these guys are fakers.
Perry, again, let me explain how stupid you are.
Let me explain how stupid you are.
Shut the fuck up and
you're
listen.
You're fucking ripping on me.
That three guys dressed like this for Halloween, that's a bad thing, you fucking moron.
Well, you didn't explain yourself, you fucking moron.
Sign it before the pen goes out. On this one, sign it smaller and sign again, but don't write as big as you did.
Oh, Christ.
Come on, just fucking sign the picture.
Shut up.
God, you're a dreadful fucking person.
Let's not shut that out of the energy right at the gate.
Goodbye. The show's over.
There's no more fucking podcast.
Because you guys are a bunch of fucking pricks.
That's the energy we're looking for.
Sign the picture. Oh, you fucking moron.
Shut the fuck up, you cocksucker.
Keep a fucking pen together, you moron.
What are you guys talking about?
Your fucking partner over here is giving me shit because he's got his head up his ass.
You're a fucking idiot.
You're the hostile brothers. You guys are the partners. You're the guys who yell at everybody.
All right, now.
I got it, you fucking prick.
Right, here, let him sign this last one. Sign this last one.
Who does it go to?
It doesn't matter. Write good luck. Write something besides your just dumbass name.
Christ almighty.
You all right, buddy?
No!
He's talking to me.
Good luck.
I'm talking to both you guys. You're both my best buddies.
Just sign the fucking
thing. I hate to see you guys yelling at each other so much. What are you writing, Skidmaster?
Don't worry about it.
Well, what is it?
Disrespectful?
I said, you treat me like shit!
Stop getting under my skin! I said hand it to me and you throw it to me?
Yeah, he's scary.
Fuck!
Hurry.
Shut up! I'm tired of your fucking horse shit, man. I asked you to please hand it to me. I didn't yell at you.
It is.
I'll cut your fucking eye open. Don't be stupid.
Don't cut his eye open, dude.
All right, I won't.
All right, let's all take it.
I'm not, what's his name in the movie The Godfather where you fucking put a bullet through my eye?
I'm Mo Green.
That's it, Mo.
Hey, Mo.
Remember, you're Mo, I'm Larry, and he's Curly.
Yeah, come on, dude.
Or is it the other way around?
All right, well, that was our podcast this week. Join us next week.
I'm sick and tired of this faggot shit online, too. About people trying to hook me up with that fucking cocksucker that did what he did back in 1992. I mean,
what are you
Christ,
talking about?
Lance Bass?
I'm not even gonna bring up a name.
Pee Wee Herman.
Next.
Wait a minute. Who are you talking about?
People are giving me shit and talking shit about
who?
RC.
The Cola?
Royal Crown.
Randy Callahan.
Oh yeah, I've noticed that. How did that whole thing get started?
Can we even start the show before he's got to bring him up?
I don't even want to talk about the piece of shit again.
We should get the show started.
Start it.
You know, this song would be a good way to start the show.
Mm-hmm.
Coming to you pre-recorded from Simply Don, the podcast network studios at a secret location in West Hollywood, California. It's the Big Three Podcast. Hi, I'm your pal Don Barris.
My name is Walter.
And I'm, of course, the Scaremaster, Scary Perry.
You sound like Eeyore.
Well, that's what happens when all you keep doing is taking those Quaaludes.
You got some ludes?
You don't have any Quaaludes.
I wish
no,
I
he
had
does.
What?
I have some, but I don't have enough. That's from my Cheech and Chong. I've been smoking.
Now, you came in on fire today.
Yeah,
what's going on? Why do you got to come in such a prick? We got a big show, so get to the point.
Well, you know, I got a lot of legal shit that I'm doing this week. So,
okay.
I'm in court tomorrow. I'm in court Wednesday. I'm in court Friday.
Okay. Is it my fault?
It's not your fault.
Well, okay. Before we go any farther, we got to do this. Everyone is so concerned. So let's start off the show with what they want to hear about. The Cookie Caramello update.
Drum roll, please.
Is he still alive?
Yes, he is.
Okay, that's spectacular.
Yes, he is.
What did he have for breakfast?
I don't know.
Now, if you don't know about Cookie Caramello, that's Perry's father and...
Sonny Chris Caravello.
And on February 6th, they had the plug pulled.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he's been hanging on ever since.
And he came home even.
He came home?
Yeah.
Why did they have him all plugged up if he's able to come home now?
Was it a big mix-up?
He came home because he just got sick and tired of the mistreatment in the hospital. So, he's healthier than an ox is what I like to say.
Really?
Yeah, the guy's amazing.
When you say mistreatment at the hospital?
Well, because at the VA clinic.
Hold on. I know. We know the stories. I heard about what happened with him when he went in there. He said, I can get all the ice cream I want. But
it's got nothing to do with ice cream.
No, they said you can have all the ice cream you want, but whenever he falls in the shower, all the orderlies nail him from behind, screaming, I'm Al Capone.
Seriously?
Apparently.
What the fuck are you talking about?
So why would they do that to him when...
Because his father. His father, to honor his dad.
Well, speaking of honor...
Oh, Christ.
The holiday that we've all been waiting for is just around the corner, and I got to tell you, people are going absolutely crazy on this. June 26th, as you know, is the 20th anniversary of Perry and Randy Callahan hooking up. Now, before the show, you were saying a lot of people are getting in contact with you about that.
Yeah, I'm just tired of this fucking faggot crap. Okay? I'm tired of it.
Can I make
it's one? Something that happened to me 20 fucking years
Not
ago.
Not quite 20. Soon it'll be 20.
Yeah.
It's so fucking close. I'm just sick and tired of it.
Well, here's the deal. You know, I don't know what they're doing with you, but people are offering big contracts for even myself to go to some of these celebrations, I guess.
I may be signed up to the big one, Tehachapi. You guys, by the way, I need to mention that if you mention the code BIG3RCHOLIDAY, this is the Extended Stay America in Tehachapi, they will give you 30% off and complimentary continents of breakfast.
But through Tehachapi, haven't they really jacked up the prices at hotels for this thing?
Yeah, well, there's still rooms available, but be sure to mention Big 3 RC Holiday.
Here's the thing about Tehachapi. The only thing that's in Tehachapi is a fucking prison.
But there's the motels around there.
So people that have to go up and visit their friends, family, and relatives in the fucking jail, they stay in those fucking hotels.
Yeah, but
that's
that weekend it's going to be tough for them because the holiday's going on.
God.
So how are you handling this whole thing with the Randy Callahan 20th anniversary?
I'm not interested.
Come to the one in Tehachapi.
Fuck you
go
guys.
Go to the one in Tehachapi.
Fuck you guys.
Oh,
fuck you guys, period.
But I don't understand.
Fuck everybody. I want nothing to do with what happened to me 20 fucking years ago.
There's the butter churning competition.
Wait a second. There is a butter churning competition?
You know, I don't know if you remember this, but originally when I got into the project, it was through Land O'Lakes Butter. They've come back around
Christ.
20 years later.
Land O'Lakes Butter had nothing to do with it.
I know, but...
You ate a fucking big cocksucking tub of Wesson grease... oil shortening at the fucking Comedy Store.
That was his second time.
No, that was the first time I ever saw him at the
OR. No, the first time was a whole stick of butter.
That's when you met him?
No.
Before I met him?
I won the look.
Because I...
He won the No.
Then I didn't know anything about the Land O'Lakes butter deal.
You were there.
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were.
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were.
I will argue with you until the day you die. The first time I met this guy, which was in the OR room, I'll never forget that fucking crazy ass night.
Yeah, I'd like to hear it.
It was a so-called competition that I knew nothing about until I got on stage. Then all of a sudden this guy opens up a big fucking can of Wesson shortening and scoops it out with his bare fucking hands.
Okay, first of all,
and eats this shit. Not just, what was it, one can or two?
Perry,
I don't know.
Perry, can I just tell you
this? It was a lot of shortening. He ate it raw like he has never eaten a fucking meal.
Perry, the first time you met him was at the Look Mom at Simply Don because he was in Milwaukee.
No, it wasn't.
He was flown out here then. You're going to, Mole, am I crazy about this?
Anyway, Land O'Lakes butter, and he's right. I was into shortening at the time, too. But, you know, that's a Wisconsin thing. It's what we would do to keep warm in the winter.
And the second show that he was there, he got into the Crisco.
But anyway.
I got video to prove it, Perry.
At the Big 3
whatever,
RC.
Big whatever.
Three, big you think I'm lying?
If you could show me the one with the fucking butter
yeah.
sticks where I am in. That's bullshit, though, because I'll tell you what.
What?
Because I know how this fucking system is working in this town called Hollywood.
Yeah.
You guys are masking one thing after another to make it look like I'm in this show or in that show or I'm here or I'm there.
What are you
and
talking
even like
about?
I'm fucking sucking a goddamn dick.
What?
Which is bullshit.
What are you
I've
talking
learned.
About?
People
I don't
online,
get it.
People online are masking one thing after another to make it look like I'm giving a blowjob
to
somebody.
To who?
Whatever. But it's all
listen,
a lie.
We don't know what you do it's, during the week, Scaremaster, all right?
I know what I do during the
but
week.
But how do you include us in on this? We have nothing to do with that.
Because you're Hollywood. That's what I
include. Represent Hollywood to you?
That's my...
You are Hollywood Dan.
Thank you. That's
let's
a compliment.
Start calling that
in
Hollywood
a way, yes,
Dan.
It is a compliment. And if it wasn't for you, I would never have become the star of Windy City Eats. Or excuse me, Comedy Central's Windy City Heat. And I thank you and thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Well, thank you for finally admitting to something. But why are you blaming me for what they say online about
I'm
you
not blaming you for
people?
What
and
you
and if people want to put pictures on the
whoa,
things
whoa.
That you
time
do
out, Mo,
dudes,
shut up!
If this picture of what
shut
you
up!
Do with other dudes that aren't part of the Big 3 RC holiday in Tehachapi, that's your own business.
I'm not involved with that garbage. I'm not involved with all
you
that.
You could win that
Perry,
butter competition.
Can I just say one thing? Are you ever going to take back the Randy Callahan thing? Can you ever take back time and go?
What do you mean take back?
Can you ever go back 20 years and take back what you did with Randy?
No, you can't. You can't remove what happened to you yesterday.
So why don't you make some money off it?
How can I make money off of
it? Because they're offering me money to go host little things. There's some concert, I think...
Not going to some jailhouse city called Tehachapi or to the jail.
Okay, but there's
to film anything.
There's even smaller ones. I'm doing something. I think I'm the opening act for Aha. I think they're playing in Barstow during the holiday.
I'm gonna be
what?
I'm gonna be and Perry, you should get on this. I'm gonna be backing up Looking Glass. They're gonna be performing a Randy to the tune Brandy.
Randy, you're a fine guy. Okay. What a good boss you would be.
Such a fine guy.
I want nothing to do with that garbage.
Why don't you sing it?
For what?
Well,
how much are you going to pay me?
Well, you could either do that one or you could do
Period. What I need, what I want to do.
I'm just saying, wouldn't you want to make money off this thing?
I want to make money doing a fucking movie or a TV show.
All right, but you know what? In the time being, if somebody paid you $500 to go open a show during the celebration.
Well, is somebody going to offer me that kind of money?
How about if you got Cameo and you guys do Randy to the tune Candy?
How much are you going to pay me for the Cameo?
Like the Cameo song?
Looks like Randy.
Looks like Randy.
I need the $500 up front.
Yeah, that's the way they do
how
it.
How about
that's not the way they do it.
How about working with Bruce Springsteen and you could do in Randy's room?
I'll work with Bruce. I'll even work
in
with
Randy's
Tommy
room.
Lee and
8x10 pictures
and,
on the
Neil.
Wall.
Vince Neil. I'll work with the Motley Crue on anything that they want to do.
Yeah, anything they want to do.
Not gay.
You
well,
just
why
said
would you
anything.
Say that?
I said anything meaning
you
rock
did
and
say
roll.
That's a
but
meant
you didn't
rock
say that.
And roll.
Well, you didn't say that.
You really didn't say that.
Hey,
that's what
oh,
you said.
God, you guys are such queers.
Oh, true. By the way, you know, we got a lot of mixed reviews about Neil Leeds' appearance last week.
Have you heard his new You're Raping Me, Neil spot?
No, Christ.
I haven't heard him yet. I really haven't.
Hope he does him soon.
Some people, they never want to see Neil on this show again. And some people, there was one guy that thinks he should become the mayor of Los Angeles because of some of his views. What do you think of him, Perry?
You know, Mr. Leeds is a nice guy.
I thought he was a good guy.
He's a good person. He's got his business. We got ours. If he wants to sponsor the show again, I'll accept him sponsoring the show again.
Well, he never really sponsored the show in the first place.
Well,
the real excitement comes from three of the people in this room.
Don, Mole, and Scary. That's
no,
me.
No, actually, this is not you, but it involves Mary Jane.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Because
Mary Jane.
Mole's Money Bucks. Now, if you're not familiar with what's been going on, Right before the Super Bowl, Mole made a prediction during Mole play where he said that New England would be down by 4 points. They would be driving in the final moments of the game. Well, that's exactly what happened. So we did a little experiment to see how good Mole could make bets and things like that, if he could really predict things. The first thing we did, we got involved with a 10-team upsets parlay. Well, he got all 10 of those right, got the upsets right. Then last week, he got involved with the England versus Pakistan cricket 3-game series. We won that. So our total winnings so far went up to $146,520. Now, we've tried to include Perry on this. And this week, Mole, you went to Las Vegas.
Yes, I did.
And you played a little blackjack.
Big time.
All right. Now, this is what's ballsy. This is why I think something's going on with Mole. I think he can't lose. Now, Mole, you played one hand of blackjack. You put the entire thing on one hand.
Yeah, you know what I ended up getting?
What's that?
I got two cards.
Right, of course you do.
I got an 8 and a 6.
Equaling 14. Now, here's what he did. This is what takes balls. The dealer showed a face card.
Yeah, they showed me one of their cards. It was a face card, which is worth like almost like 10.
Well, it was exactly 10, and they turned that over. That's part of the game. You took a hit on 14.
Well, you know what the thing was? I don't think I was supposed to do that, but they go, do you want a hit? And I'm like, yeah, I want a hit. And then they gave me another card. I was like, I didn't want
And what card. Was that other card?
The other card was a 7.
Making it 21.
But they had another picture card.
So they had
which
20.
Which was like almost another 10.
So we doubled our money again, bringing our new total of winnings that we have won. Just originally, it was just on our $10 shout-outs between Mary Jane, myself, and Mole.
And Scaremaster.
No, he's not part of this. He doesn't want to be part of it.
Why didn't
Until
you-
when?
He Why brings our total to $292,840.
So that's basically $293. $293,000.
Pretty close.
Okay, what do I have to do to get involved in being a
Why
part of...
Why weren't you involved last week?
Because...
He didn't want to put his money up.
I am so broke, and I still need money.
But what happened last week? Didn't we try to get you in it?
Yeah, we gave him a break. We let him try to eat a pie.
Oh, the cherry pie that you wouldn't eat.
He couldn't do it in 3.5 minutes.
I couldn't do it in 3.5 minutes. I can't eat that fast.
He wasn't part of it.
Oh, he had 4 minutes.
No, he only had 3.5. Went down to 3.5.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow, that's a bummer. Why didn't you ask for a pie extension?
That I was kind of surprised about.
I didn't know about those.
What are you talking
what do you mean?
About?
We've That's had like all we talk about is
three
pie
extensions already on the show.
You got to learn how to play the game. When
all
you're
right,
eating
I,
pie,
right,
you got to
go
for the
pie
extension.
For pie extensions.
Yeah. Come on, get your shit
what you
together.
You had a cake extension a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, that worked out good for you.
Yeah, right. You scored on the cake extension.
We have a total of $292,840. Now, Mary Jane, you're kind of the crazy one. Do we take a chance and go with Mole again?
Question.
Shoot.
Is that each or split?
We split that.
Let it ride.
Let it ride. Okay. Now, what do you want to do this week?
If I got involved with this...
What's that? You got to put up your money.
How? What? All of it?
All of it.
Fuck. I couldn't keep at least $20?
No.
And then if I put up all of my money into next week's
bet, you could lose it too. That's the thing about betting. You know, I need a car. You know, I was in an accident. I'd like to take the money now, but
that's what you should do.
Well, Mary Jane, for some reason, wants to let it ride, and
She's
I've
got
said
a feeling.
One for all and all for one is what I've said.
More money, please.
More money.
Okay, so. What do you want to do? Do you want to put your money up this week?
How much money am I going to be getting this week?
Let's find out. I think that on this one,
don't know how
it's
much you're gonna
5
get.
To 1 odds. So it's pretty risky. It's pretty risky.
Jesus Christ. But if I put up what I'm supposed to get...
You don't get part of our thing. I don't think that's fair. Whatever the $10 shout-outs are, you have to put that up. Now, you will get a percentage of that, like you're making a bet on your own, because you can't really be part of our team. I don't think that's fair.
What do you think, Scaremaster?
If I throw in...
Your $10 shout-outs.
My $10 shout-outs for this week, and I don't know how much the $10 shout-outs are. Let's add up the $10 shout-outs, and then we'll talk about it.
Oh, you want to talk about it later?
Yeah, let's add up. First, we need to add up the $10 shout-outs.
Look,
it goes like this. I cannot give up all my money.
Okay, so all right. So do it next week.
Let's talk about how much.
Then do it next week. See if this works this week. Because this one, the odds are pretty high here. We could lose this one. Do you know what he's going with? He's going with a Big Ten tourney
and conference tournament upset.
Do you know what that means?
No.
He has to pick the final four of the Big Ten Conference Championship Series. And then throughout all of basketball, he has to pick two upsets.
You know who I'm going to go with?
Well, do you want to be part of this, yes or no? It's a pretty difficult bet. I'm going to tell you that. Do you want to go with it, yes or no?
I need to know how much we got in the shout-out.
Well, okay, you can't do that. It's got to be a gamble.
Don. The reason why I can't gamble and the reason why I don't gamble is because I lose gambles.
Yeah. Well, Mole's been on a winning streak. The one that blew me away was the 10-team plus upset parlay. That was amazing. I've never seen anyone win that before. So he's been on a roll, but is our luck run out? Do you want to wait one more week, or do you want to do this?
Because of me being so fucking broke, I can't.
Okay.
Can't afford it.
Okay, I'm going with.
All right, then here's
OSU over Michigan, MSU over Wisconsin.
Wait a minute. So you're saying in the Final Four, Ohio State's going to beat Michigan?
Yes.
Sorry, buddy. Okay, and then who else?
Michigan State over Wisconsin.
Okay, so it's Michigan State and Ohio State in the finals.
Yes.
And who's going to win that?
I'm going to go Michigan State over Ohio State. That one's for you.
Thank you.
That's for you, buddy.
That's cool. Now, who are your two upsets? This is where it really gets crazy.
Okay. They just got destroyed by tornadoes, so their head's not in the game. I gotta go. I'm sorry, man. Tough times for them, but Kentucky's
the toughest team in all
of
basketball.
Their heads aren't in the game, man. They got too much tragedy going on. Also, North Carolina.
You're picking two of the teams that are favored.
Sorry.
To win the. Oh man.
Oh boy.
Perry.
I'm laughing because I don't keep up with these games.
Okay, well, Sunday we'll see what happens.
I don't keep up with these games,
okay.
So that's why I...
We'll find out. Hey, what else is going on, you guys?
Well, I'll tell you what's going on. What's really kind of crazy, and I don't know who originally came up with this, but every time I go to my Facebook page, the stickers of Perry are going up everywhere. The ones that say gay and that have the question mark. They're going up.
You know where I saw one?
United States and Canada. Where'd you see it? I'm sorry.
You know that giant boulder that was being moved across Los Angeles to the Los Angeles County Museum of Art? They had stickers of it all over that.
Are you serious?
Yeah, are you serious?
This is
fucking crazy.
We have nothing to do with it, yet everybody's seen this.
This is fucking crazy.
Yeah. Wow.
I wanna say something
to
one of our fans. Okay, actually, two of them, and I don't even remember their names.
Well, this is a good shout out for them.
The problem is they mailed me a laptop computer.
That's like a $10 shout out.
Yeah, they gave you a computer.
They gave me a laptop computer.
Does it work?
Oh yeah, it works. I brought it over to my technician, and he checked it all out to make sure there was no bugs on it and stuff. And
what kind of computer?
It's a Toshiba.
It's a Toshiba.
It's your mail ticket.
Remember that?
Oh, God.
Remember Sheba?
Fucking Sheba.
And now you got a computer.
She was your meal ticket. Now she's your lap.
She's not a meal ticket.
It's the second time she's been on your lap.
Oh, thanks.
But, yeah, so have you put up any stickers?
No.
I've got some stickers.
I got a bunch of stickers, too.
Start putting them up and taking pictures by them. And put them online. Because it's promotion. Don't you think?
I'm not gay.
Explain.
But, meaning I'm not a faggot. Gay, happy, yeah.
You are happy.
I can be.
Be happy.
I can also be very angry, too.
You sure can. You got a lot of emotions going on.
This upcoming Sunday, what we have to do is we have to go to the marathon because Mole is running the marathon.
Yeah,
still
here's the
do
road
that?
Closures, guys. Here's the map of the road closures.
Okay.
So I'm gonna figure out what time I'm gonna be over by here. Scare Mash, you're gonna have to get here early, buddy.
6 a.m. 5 a.m.
No, there's no way in hell that's happening.
You're gonna be all.
Nah, I'm gonna get over here. You'll be sleeping when I'm running by. We'll figure it out, though.
Okay, but you're going to do this next week, right?
Maybe.
Next Sunday.
Maybe.
What do you mean, maybe?
That's what I said, maybe.
I think it's about time to do something where the fans can get involved. This is a segment of the show where you, the listener, can be part of the fun here. Now, here's all you have to do. You send $10 to us, cash, no checks, no money orders, none of that legal mumbo-jumbo. And if you do that, you'll get a mention on the show. Now, you'll send that to 7510 Sunset Boulevard, number 153, Hollywood, California, 90046. So, once again, it's time for our $10 shout-out.
$10 shout-out!
Perry, why don't you read this one? We'll have you read because you haven't read much lately.
All right.
Take this.
Dear Big Three, I recently discovered that I may have something in common with the Scare Master. Last year, I had surgery at Kaiser Hospital in Hollywood, where I met the most beautiful and exciting woman in the world. Her name is Martha, and she's a nurse who gave me sponge baths during my recovery. The first sponge bath involved her handling my package quite a bit. Being a real man, no amount of painkillers could ever hold back my erection. For this super hot chick, I was a little embarrassed. What was that? Yeah, I was a little embarrassed, and all I could think to say was, "Honey, I want you to come home with me and do this every night of the week forever." Her first response was to say that wasn't appropriate. But then she realized she had my hard dick in her hand. From then on, she gave me a couple of sponge baths a day, and every visit had a happy ending. Martha and I eventually got married, and don't tell anyone, but she's nastier than 10 porn stars put together. Some guys might feel a little jealous or insecure that their wives handled the penis of such a famous celebrity like Perry Caravello. I'm removing that M and putting a V there. Like,
why do people say that?
Because they're idiots, Caramello. But Martha told me how small and flimsy his dick was. So this day, we still get a huge laugh every time we hear Perry say, "Unleash the Fury." Signed, Walter Payton.
Wait a minute. Is that the same Martha that was the nurse over
I doubt
Kaiser
it.
When you were there?
I doubt it. And I don't believe
it. Yeah, it's because Martha
I don't
was the
believe
same
it's
one
the same
you.
Walter Payton from the Chicago Bears. Because Walter Payton from the Chicago Bears is dead.
That's probably a different guy with that name.
CPA.
This one is from Def Flow Records. Dear Big Three, I'm a fan of the podcast and all the good shit, but I got to say, I'm sick of seeing my man Perry getting schooled like you always do at rapping with that punk-ass sucka-sucka Ali come through with his played-out Yo Perry track. Perry needs some help making a comeback record, and that motherfucker Salvador stole his $500 Benjamins and gave him one weak-ass line of, "My name is Scary Perry Caravello. I hail from Chi-Town, so you know I'm a good fellow. My name is Scary Perry Caravello." Shit, I'm not surprised that ruckus is schooling Perry with lines like this. So because I love Perry so much, I wrote him this comeback rap.
Oh,
and
sweet.
It's free. It's free, son.
Cool.
So Don Barris, tell DJ Joe Montana's little brother to drop a sick beat and let Perry rip and do his shit. Get him, Perry. All right, this looks like... Okay,
let me bust that. Let me try to bust
right.
this.
You want to do it from the beginning?
1, 2, 3, and to the...
Because Perry's about to do the rapping stuff.
Give me the residuals first so I can sue like a fool. In my Toyota 94, watching the girls leave from school. Ain't nothing but an at-P thing. Randy, I'm a broke neck Dago named Scary.
Barry.
Death Flow is the label that
pays
me. Unstakable, so Tempur-Pedic, don't even try this. But now back to the ruck at hand. I'm dealing with a high school punk from Michigan. From in old Pete Lowe's perspective, before I eat some dairy, I had to find a laxative. I never know I could be eating some ham and yelling at Dan at the same time blowing a man. But you know, I ain't the gay shit, Lieutenant. Ain't no rectum good enough to get AIDS while I'm up in it. And that's realer than get a deal mattress deal. So at $6.99, my skate decks are a steal. And if you don't want to end up like that Nathaniel kid, you forget all about that gay shit. And if you don't want to end up like that Nathaniel kid, you forget all about the gay ass that I did. It's like this and like that and like this and oh! It's like this and like that and like this and
oh!
Like this and like that and like this and
oh!
It's like this. It's like this. And yes, of course I rape toes. So just chill, Rucker, while I take off your clothes. Well, end the first verse. That was pretty hot.
It was pretty hot. So that helps
ain't
you
nothing
out.
Nothing but a pee thing.
Dr. J. Rakim Mathers, Death Row Records, City of Compton, Los Angeles, Cali.
Death Row Records.
Death Flow Records.
Death Flow?
Death Flow.
Death Flow, okay.
Death Flow.
Yes, Amasa.
What are you talking like that?
I was going to get racist.
Yeah.
Death Flow.
All right, here's one from Maul.
Oh. Uh-oh. I got to read?
Yeah. Do you have your glasses? Because I can't see where shit in this light. And I can't... This is
small. Well, those are really small.
Yeah.
It's really small.
I can't see that one at all.
It's the from the Van Nuys Unfinished Film Festival. Dear Mr. Caravelli, sure you're aware, we at the Van Nuys Unfinished Film Festival take great pride in integrity as well as our accuracy. In order to maintain our commitment to excellence, we run an annual audit on all votes cast for awards given to recipients. Therefore, it's much regret to inform you that Vonder Award, given to you, your... Portrayal of Legendary Stone Fury is given to an error. Some absentee ballots from the year were found in the collection of Sal Minko's Underground Gay Films. The addition is newfound ballots. Therefore, the star of the unfinished short film and actual winner of the Vonder is Mr. Andrew Dice Clay. The gritty portrayal of an unemployed lowlife personifies the Italian-American experience. We apologize for any mistake that is called. We would normally require you to return the trophy on damage, of course, but we have obtained a larger trophy, a much higher quality to give to the rightful winner, please accept the enclosed $15 consolation prize for coming behind Andrew Dice Clay. Sincerely yours, Jennifer Marlowe.
What?
Oh, too bad.
They're saying that there were votes that were not counted in the Van Nuys Film Festival, and that Dice actually won that.
Crack of shit.
So you got to return in your...
Bullshit. Well,
no, they said he doesn't have to. They got him a new one.
All right, here's the next one. My name is Scott Horton, and my friends and I went out for you guys this year on Halloween. My friend T.J. Cowley went as Mole, my roommate Denver Cross went as Don, and I was the Scaremaster himself, Perry. I was hoping each of you could autograph our pictures that we took. But more importantly, I was writing Perry to ask how he felt about Mole being portrayed by a black man. Did you know that?
No.
Did you see the
that
pictures?
That is awesome.
What? It's, you mean the pictures you made me sign?
Yeah, the pictures that you signed, yeah.
I was portrayed as I should be, as a proud man of color.
I know his racist Javajo heart has no room for tolerance, but his homosexuality, blood, and the fact he blew Randy Callan and Sandy Gallagher suggest otherwise. I would also like my $10 shout-out to go towards a new diaper for Perry's reprisal of the much-loved Big Baby Guy sketch. Thank you so much, Scott Horton, T.J. Cowley, and Denver Cross.
It goes like this. You know, all that gay garbage is completely garbage. Because I'm not gay. I'm not a faggot.
It's somewhat inaccurate.
I'm not a
folks.
Homosexual. Somewhat? You mean it's completely inaccurate?
Who cares?
Well, not completely, because there's that one thing.
20 fucking years ago.
You're the one who brought it up.
You are the one that brought it up.
You want me out of this show? I'll never bring it up again. I'm just tired of it happening.
What happened again?
It'll never happen again.
Well, how are you tired of it happening?
Tired of it being mentioned
on the
internet.
You said you were tired of it happening.
Did like,
being mentioned on the fucking internet. Just shut your fucking mouth.
Happening. Like,
you're
it's
saying confusing
thing.
Things when you say that you do.
I'm tired of it.
It's a recurring.
Stop fucking bringing it up.
Happen. Who's bringing it up?
Everybody that sends you stupid shit.
All right. Well, this one, this letter you might like a little better. Here, why don't you read this?
Dear Big Three, I'm sick of the insults against Perry. It's time for Don and Mole to take their fair share of insults. Screw you, Mole. You are way too loyal to Don and Perry. What's that? Yeah, again, screw you, Mole. You are way too loyal to Don and Perry. Plus, Your mole play completely fail at being, plus your mole plays completely fail at being pedestrian. Don, you are a complete jerk. What? How dare you? You selfish son of a bitch.
Well, who said that?
First, you devote way too much time, way too much time to your work. And second, you never, I'm reading it the way it's written. And second, you never, and I repeat, never act unprofessional. Perry, you deserve major praise. This shout out goes to you. You and I, you are honest about your personal life and think before you act.
And you're talking
and
about
pop culture.
You never
deny that you blew Randy Callahan. Say that again. You're honest about your personal life. You think before you act, and you never deny. No, because I never did blow a guy named Randy Callahan.
Okay, well, read
what's
what they
name?
Said.
Everyone thinks his name is.
Yeah, it says you blew a guy named Randy Callahan. Okay, your number three fan, Barry Lou Henner. Who the hell is Barry Lou Henner?
Well, we have a lot of fans that you don't know.
Whatever.
All right, Mullen, here's the last $10 shout-out. Why don't you read this for us?
Okie dokie. Dear Perry, you continue to fill my dreams with passion every night. Last night, we were out dancing at one of our favorite gay clubs. You had your shirt off, and you were showing me your sexy dance moves. Suddenly, the building burst into flames. You picked me up in your arms and saved me from the burning wreckage. It turned me on so much that I had to have you right then and there. We made love on the side of the street while the patrons of the club cheered us on. I pounded your A while you moaned in pleasure until I pulled out and seed all over your back. Then I took my underpants and wiped the J off you like a gentleman. It got me thinking about a hypothetical question. If Dan Mole and Linda Johnson were trapped in a burning building and you could only save two of them, who would it be? Demetri Moreland. P.S. If you didn't choose both Dan and Mole, you're a horrible person. Mole has suffered enough from 3rd-degree burns. Meineke just got mufflers, thank you. And when you put his hand in boiling water, again, thank you. And Dan has done more for you than anyone else. That said, I would still like to meet up with you sometimes and have sex. That's a nice letter. Thank you, Demetri.
But they brought up Linda, my old Linda.
Yeah, so who would you save?
So you're in a burning elevator. There's three people in there. You can save two of them. Myself, Mole, or Linda Johnson.
Linda?
Why Linda? She doesn't do a show with you every week.
She's female. She's the only thing I could fuck.
All right, but then you've got to choose one other person between Mole and I, then. One of us.
Well, you're healthy enough to help save yourself, couldn't you?
No, he's not going to make it. It's only
one. All right, then I save you, and I get rid of, and I let you save yourself.
No, but they're not going to. Whoever you leave behind dies.
On one rope. I'm your best friend. I'm your best friend.
Who are you going to choose, Perry?
The guy that helped put me into fucking show business. The guy that helped the guy that helped make me the star of the City Heat.
Yes. Thank you.
Okay?
Thank you.
That's why I'm saving you, you fuck.
So I'm dead.
You're not dead.
I thought you just said.
I just saved you, you. You nice guy. You warm-hearted sweetheart there.
Why does it always get turned into seducing Dan?
I'm not seducing Dan.
And that was $10 shout-outs.
$10 shout-out!
Was that a phone call that I just heard?
Who is it?
Could you send that call through, please, real quick?
Hello, how are you? Have you been all right all these long, lonely, lonely, lonely nights? Guess whom?
Hey, Mr. Adams, how are you?
Yes. Scare Master, do me a favor. Catch me up with some cookie time. Is he still ticking?
Still ticking.
That's good. Yeah, he's still
he's
alive.
With
listen to me
yeah,
for a moment. Listen
talk
to me.
Much.
I've been giving this quite a bit of thought, and the idea of you without a father is unacceptable, which is why, are you ready?
How much money are you going to help me
out with? I'm beginning the paperwork to adopt you.
Oh,
my God, that's nice.
Adopt me?
That's awesome.
I don't need to be adopted.
I understand there will be a period of adjustment. Let me just hear you say, Daddy, may I have another plum trifle?
Say it.
Daddy, may I have another plum trifle?
Daddy, may I have another plum trifle?
Say it again.
Daddy, may I have another plum trifle?
I love
trifle?
It when you call me Big Papa, yes, yes.
No, no.
Mr. Adams, how's your dog doing?
Yeah, the one with the broken neck.
Yes,
like
you know what?
Master.
It was just like Perry's broken neck, only Monsignor Winky Pinky Bottom didn't do it skateboarding at 47 years old. But thank you for asking.
I did it at 45, by the way.
Passed away.
Oh, it's terrible. He died.
But wait, listen. Nearly 2 full hours later, we were able to resuscitate him with what my shaman calls a pet cemetery serum.
Ooh, that's
terrible.
Yes, yes, he stalks around the house. He has very dead eyes and seems to be following me. Anywho, muchas gracias for your concerno. Now it's time for this week's Joke Time with Johnny. Do I get a little theme music?
I didn't know you had a title for this thing.
Joke, I like
well,
that.
Well, I'm just spitballing
joke
some
time
ideas.
With Johnny's nice. Yeah,
we read him.
It's funny.
Yeah, I do.
Go
I
ahead. Give me a joke.
What does one call a cow who plays guitar?
A musician?
Oh, well, shit. What else could it possibly be? Catch you on the Flip Wilson side. Ta!
Goodbye, Mr. Adams.
A musician because it's a cow.
You know, he really doesn't take up much time on the show every week. He's no, just kind of.
But I will tell
out.
You, that is exciting for him to be Scaremaster's new dad.
No.
That he would be nice.
Says he's no adopting need. You as soon as Cookie dies.
Well, whatever.
You don't
if
want
he's
to
gonna
do that?
Adopt me, then he's gonna have to help me out financially then.
Sure he will. He'll give you an allowance. But
are you kidding me?
Do errands and chores.
Do you know how great that would be for you?
That'd be awesome. I can
because
use it.
Because you know what?
You could live in his house.
Oh.
$1,000 a week?
Probably more.
Well, you got to see how much you could do in errands.
I mean, that's
and what kind of chores are you going to do for him?
Clean the house.
Next time he calls, let's
mow the lawn.
Him.
Yeah, you got to do that. Next time you got to start acting.
Churn
like...
the butter.
I'm not churning no butter.
Why not?
Churning the butter to makes it look like the way Mole's doing it is jerking him off.
How do you churn butter?
I don't churn butter.
Show me how you do it, though.
I don't churn butter.
If you had to
if
churn
you
butter,
had to churn butter, how would you do it?
And you mean in a fucking
like if you're
pot?
Doing like if you're churning the butter, how would you do it?
I'd be.
No, why would you go? You can't. That's stirring. You got to go up and down.
Well, then I don't do that. Anywho, when can I do my movie review?
You want to do it now?
Sure.
Show us how you churn butter, and then we'll do.
It. Scare me! I still have to do it all over your face.
Ouch! Oh, my neck is killing me.
Yeah, because you just churned butter all over it.
Yeah.
Scary Perry's movie review.
Let me introduce
brought
it.
To you by Perry's churned butter.
No, brought to you by Scary Perry skateboards.
By the way, you know what we always forget to do?
My skateboard review?
No.
Go fishing?
You're 60 seconds with Perry. We haven't done it for a while. Go!
Fucking hey, I need my eardrums. Stop making them bleed and blow. 60 seconds with Scary Perry?
Yeah.
It's Scary Perry's 60-Second Skateboard Review. And if you need to order a skateboard deck or a skateboard Scary Perry t-shirt, go to www.scaryperryskateboards.com. That's SCARYPERRYSK, the number 8, and boards.com.
Hey, whose Toyota was that parked on the ramp in front of my car today when I came in?
My mom's. Oh. My late mother's.
Oh, so she won't be bumped.
What'd you do? Fucking bash into
it? It was on that hill. It was way down the
yeah,
bottom
and
of that
and
hill.
In front of her car.
Why'd
in front
you
of
park
Mike?
Way down the bottom of that hill where I had to park in front of? I didn't know the giant hill was going to be there when you go down that ramp. Anyway, it should be okay. But we got to push our bumpers apart later.
Yeah.
Stop! And there we go. That's 60 seconds with Perry. And now for the thing that everybody seems to like. Once again, it's Perry's movie review. Now, today's movie is a very special movie. I think I actually saw this movie with you when it was at the theater. It's a movie called...
Did you and I see this movie at
yeah.
the theater?
It's called The Truman Show.
That was at the theater off of Melrose, I think?
Yes.
Yeah.
Did
starring
you get
Jim
snacks?
Carrey. No, we didn't get snacks.
What kind is your favorite snack?
I don't have any favorite snacks.
Come on.
Popcorn.
I go with caramel corn popcorn.
Caramel corn.
They don't usually have that.
Like,
what do you get for
like
candy?
Jack in the Box. I mean, Cracker Jacks.
You like that?
Yeah, I like caramel corn.
If you had to cut out one thing in your life, what would it be? Cracker Jacks
or
sucking cock?
Shut up.
Remember when you used to smoke crack? Is that where you got your love for Cracker Jacks?
Shut up. Cracker Jacks or sucking cock? I wouldn't. Never did and never will suck a dick. So why do you even bring it up?
Do you think it was Cookie Caramello's history in the Navy that draws you to eat that snack food that has the little berry homoerotic.
My dad was never gay in the Navy.
I'm talking about Cracker Jack and his dog.
What the fuck are you bringing, talking like a faggot for?
What?
Let me talk about the fucking Truman Show, you fucking idiot.
So once again, this is Perry's movie review. This week's movie, The Truman Show.
The Truman Show starred Jim Carrey. The Truman Show, I kind of felt, was like Windy City Heat, because the way you guys put Windy City Heat together, it was in a way, Windy City Heat is basically filmed about my life. As a comedian.
No, dude. No. Not about
Windy
you,
City,
it's about me, actually.
It's about
it's
myself
kind of about me.
Becoming a comedian.
Perry, really, you think that's it? Why don't you be real with what happened?
Everybody thinks they're the star of their own life movie, you know?
You see, Windy City Heat was a movie that was supposed to be a dramatic movie.
And Drew Carey wasn't
dramatic?
Even in it.
It was a movie about my fucking...
No, it wasn't. That's what they edited it into after it was done, because they dropped the money. If it wasn't for Kimmel coming up with the idea, let's do some of the behind-the-scenes stuff. And do you remember our meeting with you, myself, Mole, and Saul Steinberger with Greenbaum?
At the IHOP?
I remember that.
Yeah. You said that you wanted the movie
to
be
the star.
Yeah,
we videotaped that meeting, didn't we?
The one thing about the Truman Show that I kind of liked was the fact that when Jim Carrey as Truman Burbank in the movie was a little boy, and he felt like he killed his father when in the little boating event. And then
your dad was on a naval boat, and you killed him when you pulled the plug out.
Right.
I didn't pull
the
plug.
Was it tough to say that you wanted the plug pulled?
I didn't say that. I didn't say anything. The thing about my dad is he's still kicking, and he's home, and he's
all right. Let's not talk about your dad. We did the cookie update a little
now,
bit earlier. Let's get back to the movie review.
Back to the Truman Show.
Once again, this week's movie review, The Truman Show.
Starring Jim Carrey. Now, Truman Burbank had a little boat. Him and his father, they showed in the movie, were like in a dinghy boat, a small little sailboat, because they both went fishing out on the lake and stuff, or out at the high seas, you know.
Right off. I like high sea fruit punch.
You know what? I used to as a kid. Christ. It's not the same to me anymore. I don't
they
like it.
They always butt into my fucking reviews.
You just said high seas.
Would you guys let me finish my review, please?
Yeah, man. When does Mariah Carey come in it?
Mariah Carey was not in this movie.
You said it.
You did say it.
Who's someone going to lean on when the times get rough?
Thank you.
Who's going to talk to me into the sun?
What the fuck are you singing for when I'm doing a movie review?
Okay, once again, back to Perry's movie review. This week's movie, The Truman Show.
All right. Now, in the movie, again, Truman Burbank, crazy was that his father died in a boating accident when he was a kid, and he couldn't forgive himself for it because he felt like he was at the cause. And as he grew older, his father wasn't really dead, because he saw his father as a homeless guy in the downtown area. Then as the film ends, everyone watching could believe that he reached the end of his movie film as a film, because he opens up this door and sees the other side. You know what I'm saying? You know, he comes to a wall. The boat floats to the wall and
like
stops.
Pink Floyd, the wall?
Is it really?
Kinda.
Do they have the Pink Floyd music in this?
No.
What's your favorite tune in the wall?
I don't care. Stop, both of you.
I like
it. Stop.
Faces. What shall we do?
We're floating a boat to the end of the wall.
Education.
Stop, the both of you. Let me fucking finish. Would you fucking shut your mouth, you piece of shit? The boat?
I am just a little boy.
You know, when speaking of Pink Floyd, you know that when they edited the movie Windy City Heat, they edited it so it would go along.
We're talking about
Dark Side
the,
of the
Truman
Moon.
Show.
Yeah.
And as the movie ends, the boat hits the wall.
Open the door on the other side, dot, dot, dot. And then what, Scaremaster?
He looks through, and that's basically how the movie ends.
Really?
It's like, you know.
What did you think of the movie?
I thought the movie was fantastic. But
really?
But here's the thing about a movie like this, and then I look at my own life like a movie in a way, because we're doing the podcast. We did Windy City Heat, and it's almost like I got a camera on me all the time.
Where?
Do you really? Aren't you being a little paranoid?
I've been paranoid for years.
I'm a big star. I got a camera.
I've been paranoid for years.
So anyway, is that the end of your movie?
Yeah, that's the end of the movie review.
Right. And that was Perry's movie review.
Scary Perry's movie review.
By the way, the bosses upstairs said next week movie that you're going to be reviewing, the cult film classic, Windy City Heat.
Next week I got to review my own movie?
Yes.
Electric light.
So now, it's just three guys sitting around at a secret location somewhere in West Hollywood. It's time once again for a little guy talk.
Oh, yeah. It's guy talk. Gonna talk about the ladies. Guy talk.
What do you want to talk about? You want to talk about when I met...
I got some girl stuff to talk about, you guys.
You got some girl stuff?
Yeah. I've been training for the marathon, you know? And there's all these ladies who run in the Roadrunners Club that we run in. We run down to Malibu, and we run around Malibu. And, but you know the thing with marathon, Scaremaster, is, you know, that the ladies wear those runner shorts, those really short shorts.
Wow.
And
yeah,
they hydrate with electrolytes and stuff, you know. But sometimes when they're running a really long distance, they got to make poops, and they make the poops and go right down their legs.
Yeah, hot.
Like, you remember when there was that movie about the Boston Marathon?
No.
And that made me think about that. Like, that lady who's in that, she had the poop go down, like, she was...
Don't remember.
God, who that lady go in that movie?
I don't know. We haven't done this in quite some time, guy talk I'm referring to, because there's never, ever anything to talk about because you never...
Yeah, there is.
Well, this is the phone call that I got this week from a little guy by the name of Scary Perry Caramello, and I felt we've got to do guy talk this week.
Hey, I'm watching Jimmy Kimmel Live right now. It's 12:34. Joan Rivers is hilarious. Set me up with a date with her. Because I know how you like to set me up with old bags, you know, Blue Iris. And you know how I like to date, you know, Terry and Fuzo, because she's like my brother's age, 15 years older than me. So set me up with Joan Rivers, you know, a chick that's like, what, 30, 40 years older than me? Go right ahead. Okay, we'll talk. Bye.
What makes you think Joan Rivers would want to go out with you, Scaremaster?
Because we're both funny.
You're right.
But I'm trying to remember the one girl that I met at the Key Club. I'm talking about Drew Barrymore.
Met Drew Barrymore.
At the Key Club.
Oh, cool, man.
Years ago.
How long ago was this?
Back in 95.
Did you give her your number?
We exchanged numbers. I gave her my card, and she gave me her cell phone number.
She still have your number?
Wait a second.
That was a long time ago.
Hold everything. You're saying you met Drew Barrymore.
Yeah, at the Key Club.
And what did she say to you?
What did she say to me? Hi, you know, and...
Did you give her your number?
I gave her my card.
From the fanny pack.
From the pack.
And was she impressed by that?
Did she call you?
She never called me.
Is it still the same number?
I don't know. I don't even call
it. Yeah, it is.
Why don't we do this? Hey, listen, Drew, if you're listening, or if anyone's listening that's friends with Drew, because I know a lot of her friends listen to the show, tell her to call in next week and talk to Scaremaster.
Yeah, and if she does, we'll send her three Perry's Gay stickers.
Okay, whatever.
Hey, you know what? I didn't even see that over there. I was wondering if it came in today. And what I'm talking about right now is the finest Thai cuisine in the town. I'm talking about What the Huck. That's right, What the Huck.
I was about to say Rucka Rucka, but I don't know why I'm going to send that.
I don't either, because I said What the Huck. 323-654-7952. That's What the Huck for the finest in Thai cuisine. What's that number again,
Perry? Don't take my
word
for it.
323-654-5792.
You know what?
Did I say it correctly?
I don't know. Say it again.
323-654-5792?
7952.
I fucked up.
Yeah, you did. Again. Fuck up. What is it?
323.
Roll in Espanol.
Katie Hook. Para de primera comida de Thai. 323-654-7952.
Hey, you know, that really sounded good. Would you do today's ASM Plumbing and Porn intro?
Si. ASM Plumbing y Pornografía. Hasta un uno stop para un complemente para una plumbing y mucho, mucho hardcore hombre y hombre pornografía concerns. Está ASM Plumbing y Pornografía 440-731-9338. Está un hero de americano. Está un Tim Perpidicte terrifying.
Whatever.
Está un número uno de skateboard enthusiastimo.
Yeah, sure. He's never ridden a board in his life.
Gracias. ASM Plumbing y Pornografía.
Hi, I'm Terrifying Tim for ASM Plumbing and Porn. You want hot man-on-man films and top-notch plumbing and piping? Call ASM! Now, I may not be nearly as gay as their last spokesman, but I do know quality cornholing when I see it. Let's unclog some pipes! ASM Plumbing and Porn. Tell them Terrifying Tim sent you.
That's ASM Plumbing and Porn, 440-731-9338. What's that number, Perry?
440-731-9338.
Say it again.
440, correct?
Yes.
731, correct?
Yes.
Oh, I forgot the last four.
9338.
9338.
Well, you know what time it is now. It is time for what I consider, and a lot of people, critics and the fans, this is one time they agree upon something.
Harry's movie review?
Nope. Maybe the finest thing we do on this. It's time once again for a little mole play.
Mole play, let's play mole play. Mole play, let's play mole play. Mole play!
Now, before we get going, do you have to say anything anymore?
I just have to say that Mole Play is a proud sponsor of Save the Children from Choking Off Mole Play Pieces, worldwide organization, .org. We are committed to stopping children from both choking on mole play game pieces, the toxic residue that left on their fingers when they play the game, and also children like Nathaniel who have nothing to do with mole play but were inadvertently killed by Scaremaster.
They weren't killed by me.
Well,
okay,
was,
they weren't killed by me.
True. If it wasn't
I didn't
for you,
kill anybody.
You would have gone over to
scary bullshit.
Farm and everything would have been fine.
Yeah, sure.
I'm just telling you what happened. Why can't you take the blame for something?
Because I didn't do nothing. Everybody's
How do you
blaming
know?
Me.
How do you know?
Everybody's blaming
How
me for something
know?
I didn't
right.
even do.
Right. Yeah, you didn't do it right. You didn't do it.
How could I have done something when I wasn't Weren't even you there?
Family sad, and you keep pushing. I had nothing to do with it.
I wasn't even there.
Exactly.
Well, anyway,
my God,
if you've never heard Mole Play before, Mole Play is a game that we play. It's an improv game that we play here, and this is where Mole will set up some scene. He'll cast the scene, and then he'll direct the scene. Now, Mole, what are we going to be doing on today's Mole Play?
Today we head back to 2005 to Hollywood, California. The scene is jumping. We're in the Key Club, ladies and gentlemen. In the VIP section sits the beautiful Drew Barrymore from Charlie's
Angels. She wasn't sitting when I met her.
Don't worry about it.
All right.
Scaremaster pushes past the VIP line and says, I have to speak with Miss Barrymore. The bouncer tries to stop him, but he gives him the eyebrow. And moves right past him. He moves right and sits next to Drew Barrymore, who's had a couple drinks and is looking for some action. She's coming off a brutal split up with her on again, off again boyfriend, the Mac guy, Justin Long. Scaremaster slides up next to her and lays his best line on her. Scaremaster, you're going to play Scaremaster. Dan, you're going to play Drew Barrymore.
Okay.
You've had a couple drinks
okay.
and you're just breaking up with your boyfriend.
Now, am I attracted to Barrymore?
Of course you are. Look okay. at him.
All righty.
Scaremaster moves into Drew Barrymore and gives her his best line. M.O. play.
I just said hello.
What,
and...
what kind of, are you insane? You're in the moment.
Am I insane? Yeah, I'm insane.
In the moment.
Of course.
Mo-play. Mo-play.
Who are you? That's not what you said.
Hello.
Oh, boy.
You know who I am?
She didn't say.
I'm Drew Barrymore. I can fuck anybody.
Talk to
but
her,
to now, I'm
she
like,
didn't say I'm that.
Talking about
you
what you did. Be in the moment. We're mole playing.
Be in the moment?
Let me guess.
Here's
me,
the moment.
Let me guess. You're part ape.
I'm part ape? Yeah,
you
that's
look
right.
Like an ape.
Hey, you want to see that I didn't shave? That's right, I'm part ape.
Oh, you're part Italian. I
part
love
100%,
Italian. 100%. I miss Justin! I miss Justin!
Scaremaster rubs
I
her,
need someone
Scaremaster
else.
Rubs your leg to calm her down.
I need to lose my Justin!
Rub my stop leg. Fucking yelling.
Where's Justin?
Stop fucking yelling, you asshole!
You stop! I'm a producer! You're nothing! You're a fucking Italian goof! Rub my leg, you fucking sexy cocksucker.
Just rub the bottom of her leg.
Rub my leg. Rub my calf. Oh. You like my legs? Want to see my tattoos?
You don't have any tattoos.
I got Scaremaster,
rub her leg. Scaremaster says, let me give you one of my cards while he rubs her leg. Reaches in his
so
fanny
good.
Pack.
You touch my bag, I
you
kill
you. Reach
can
in
I...
your fanny pack and get out of car.
Don't you tell me that you'll kill me, huh?
Drew Barrymore's intrigued by his fanny pack, but wants to see what's in there.
None of your fucking business.
What are you doing?
She lunges for it.
What are you doing in there? What are you got in there?
She wants to see what's in the fanny pack.
Get
in. He gets a card.
Give me one of this.
She wants to know. She's losing her mind. She wants everything.
I
want to
fuck with Justin. Get your fucking hands out of my
Where's head. Justin? Where was he?
You just hit me. You just hit Drew Barrymore.
Scaremaster punches Drew Barrymore in the arm. Drew Barrymore looks for a Band-Aid in his bag again.
What is in here? What do you got in here? What is this?
Get your fucking hands out of my bag.
I just wanted to meet somebody
fucking
that I could
prick.
Get along.
He gives him the card and says his famous line.
What do you like? What do you like to do with your guys?
I like to fuck. I want to get fucked.
Let's get fucked, okay?
You
want
to fuck me? Come here.
No, I don't want to fuck you.
Give me a kiss.
She checks his fanny pack for condoms.
That's mole play.
You don't call that's mole play. Mole's the only one that can.
She checks his fanny pack for condoms.
Let me just see. Let me see. Out
of here. And that's mole play.
Mole play, mole play. Let's play mole play. Mole play, mole play. Let's play mole play.
Well, I see by the old clock on the wall that it's time to end this big show today. Perry, you okay?
Okay, yeah, I'm here. I'm alive.
Yeah, you okay? Mo, you okay?
I am.
By the way, don't forget, coming up soon, and I would say get your hotel reservations as quickly as possible. On June 26th, the holiday we've all been waiting to celebrate, the Randy Callahan Perry thing, so you got to get your hotel reservations if you're coming out here. We'll have something going on. I
How
know
much
that
am I getting
sure.
paid for this motherfucker?
You
got
to make
depends
your,
which party you're going to do, man.
Yeah, you got to.
You got to do one of the balls. Do one of the big balls.
That's the best thing for you. That's what I would say.
Christ. My name is being used and abused, and
nobody's making.
You guys are all trying to make a big fucking holiday out of June 26th, which is complete. Caca bullshit.
Why is it a different
I
date?
Want some fucking money.
From who?
From anybody. Look, it's because it's my what happened to me going on 20 fucking years, I want to be paid for it. I'm tired of working for free. I'm tired of working for fucking free. Doing this show is like working for free. This fucking faggot holiday event that I was involved with 20 fucking years ago. And no, I am not a fag.
June
and no, 26th,
the 20th anniversary of it.
I give a flying fuck, okay? It's something that happened to me, something that I wish I could forget about, but, you know, you can't reverse yesterday's. And let's fucking move forward and make something happen for real, like a fucking TV show or a goddamn movie. When are we going to fucking make a goddamn TV show or a fucking movie, huh?
If you want to get any of those, the stickers with Perry's head and where it says gay with the question mark, get in touch with me on my Facebook account and I can direct you where to get those. And what I suggest is you take pictures of any landmark or anything, hookers, anything that's in your town that you can put the sticker by. If you want to get in touch with us on the social networks, don't forget, I'm on Facebook at Don Barris. Mole, you are at?
Quaaludes on MySpace.
Okay, but what about your Facebook account?
Oh, yeah. Walter Molinsky.
Walter Molinsky.
Perry Caravello.
And that's K-A-R-V-E.
C-A-R is in car, A-V is in Victor, E-double-L-O.
Okay, don't forget about...
I have two Facebook accounts, one with myself, and of course, the most beautiful porn star, Victoria Givens, who is awesome at lovemaking. And then I have another Facebook account with myself.
Oh, jeez. Don't forget Tim Perpetic's Facebook account. Also, if you want to get in touch with me on
Twitter,
it's at SimplyDon1, and you are at
ScaryPerry818.
You got to get a Twitter account, Mole.
He does. He's got ScaryPerry323.
All right, anyway, put her there, guys. Here we go.
Big three.
So for myself, Don Barris, for Mole, for Perry, we'll see you next time. Catch me every night at the Comedy Store, Monday night, The Ding Dong Show, 10 o'clock. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye, everybody.